everybody. Today I'm making some banana bread. And we're gonna be making this gluten-free, although you can make it regular by just swapping out the flour. Everything else is the same, no big deal. But I wanna share with you a little story. My son and his friend went to New Zealand recently. They were traveling and they were talking with someone there about, of all things, bananas. I know, right? Really strange. But anyway, so they were talking to this guy and he was telling them that there are some fantastic bananas in Florida and that they should try them. And so my son ordered a box of bananas at a price of $97 for between 10 and 14 pounds of bananas. Pretty expensive, I know. And they decided to make some banana bread. And let me tell you, it was the best tasting banana bread that I've ever had. So if you're in Florida, you might want to check that out. The name of the website is miamifruit.org. I have no affiliation, but I just thought I'd throw it out there. Anyway, I'm Rockin' Robin, and I'm going to show you how to make some delicious banana bread using store-bought regular bananas right after this. Let's go over the ingredients. First up, we have our flour. I'm using Bob's Red Mill. This is 1-to-1 gluten-free flour. And, you know, like I said, you can swap out regular flour if you like. You need 3 bananas, good-sized bananas here, and make sure that they have quite a few brown spots on them. You want them to be nice and, you know, very ripe bananas. We'll need a couple of eggs, some white sugar. I have some raw honey here, vanilla extract, some butter. For our spices, I've got some baking soda, salt, cinnamon, and nuts. I'm using some walnuts here. You can either leave them in or take them out, either way. You want to preheat your oven to 350 degrees Fahrenheit, and you want to have a pan, a loaf pan like this. A metal works the best, I think. And we're going to coat this with some butter so that the bread doesn't stick. Now, I like using butter instead of, you know, the sprays because of the propellants. I'd rather eat butter. So that's what we'll do here. I'll take some butter and we'll start spreading it throughout the pan. All right, so now we're going to take our ingredients and we're going to put them basically into two bowls. We're going to have the bowl with the dry ingredients and the bowl with the wet ingredients. So we'll start with the dry ingredients. I have my flour in the bowl already. I'm going to add the sugar to it, the baking soda, the salt, and the cinnamon. Now you want to whisk this really well to combine everything, because once we add our dry ingredients to our wet ingredients, we're just going to fold it in. We don't want to overmix. So we got to start out already having everything well combined. Now for our wet ingredients, I'm going to take the butter and I'm going to melt it in the microwave. Now how I do it typically is I'll place it in there for about 45 seconds on power level 3. Take it out, stir it up, and once it's all melted, then you're good to go. But don't boil it or don't, you know, make it splatter. So I'm going to peel my bananas. And I'm going to put everything in here, even the bruises. I'm not going to worry about that. You want to make sure that these bananas are nice and ripe. That way they'll be nice and sweet, and your banana bread will just turn out so much better. So buy them ahead of time, let them sit on your counter, and they will ripen up. Now we want to mash them. And you want to keep mashing these until they turn into, you know, they get really mushy, almost liquidy-like. Now next we're going to toss in that melted butter. And you want to use a spatula to get every last drop out of there. All right, now we're going to add in the vanilla extract. Now we want to get our eggs in a separate bowl and whisk them up separately so that, you know, we get them really well combined. We get that egg yolk and the whites mixed together well. Once those are mixed up good, we'll place them in our wet mixture. And the last wet ingredient we have is the honey. So if you were to use all sugar in this, you would use 1 cup of sugar, by the way. I'll put that down in the description of the video where you can find the written recipe. I'll put the conversions down there for you in case you want to use just all white sugar. And we're going to add that to our wet ingredients. Okay, so now you want to just make sure that everything is really well combined and that honey is, you know, really combined in there and dispersed. Okay, now what we do is we just take all of our dry ingredients and just pour it into the wet ingredients. And we're going to fold this in. You don't want to overmix, but you just want to make sure everything gets wet, okay? Okay, I'm gonna toss in the walnuts. Remember, this is optional. If you want them, you can have them. If you don't want them, you just leave them out. So just keep folding things in until everything, all the flour mixture looks like it's, you know, mixed in. All right, so now we're ready to pour this in our pan. Just spread it out a little bit, push it into all the corners. Now we're gonna pop this in the oven at 350 degrees Fahrenheit, and we're gonna check it at 45 minutes with a toothpick and see if it comes out dry. All right, so we're gonna test our bread. It's been 45 minutes. What we're looking for is a clean toothpick coming out of here. Okay, so it's a little wet right there. There's still some moisture coming out on the toothpick, so we're gonna go another 5 minutes. Now you wanna do this every 5 minutes until you get a clean toothpick. All right, I let my banana bread cook about 55 minutes. Remember, ovens will vary, and it smells incredible. Love the smell. All right, I'm gonna cut into it. It's still warm. You know how I like to eat my banana bread? I really love it with a little bit of butter on it. Ooh, it's still pretty hot, especially when it's hot like this, when it's warm. Ooh. So I'm gonna put a little butter on mine. Let that melt a second. And then take a bite. Mmm. Really delicious, guys. It's moist. A beautiful banana flavor and aroma. I like the little walnuts in there, a little bit of crunch. Very delicious. Man, you guys are gonna love this. Mmm, so good. Love the little bit of hint of cinnamon in there. Man, I really love the moistness though. That's the kick. That's the real thing for me. Love that. It's very delicious. You guys are gonna love this. So thanks so much for watching, guys. Hey, if you'd like to subscribe to my channel, click the subscribe button right here at the end of the video. And we also have another subscribe button down below the video, along with that bell. Now you know what that bell is, right? That bell notifies you when my new videos come out every week. That way you don't miss anything. All right, so thanks so much for watching, everybody. We'll see you next time.